So the reason we do what we do is because we're crazy?
Yep. You know, I have always said, you know, and I think you've seen the quote on Facebook, the definition of an entrepreneur is somebody who will work 80 hours a week to avoid working 40 hours a week for somebody else. And so, you know, to me, that tells me that entrepreneurs and people who have a desire or drive to do something have a little bit of a crazy gene. And I mean that in the best possible sense.
The good crazy.
Yes.
Yeah. Kimberly Stumpf is a massage therapist in, I believe, Iowa, that I've taken a class with before up and around the Chicago area. She wrote me and she was asking for business advice, and I talked with her briefly, I believe last night on the phone. I was telling her to join the Massage Entrepreneurs Group to get information, because it's one thing when I give somebody information. It's another thing when you get information from 10 different people.
Right.
With different backgrounds, mm-hmm. You get a more well-rounded approach.
Yeah, definitely.
And Kimberly, Kim Stumpf, she wrote this morning, or actually not this morning, just 6 minutes ago on the Massage Entrepreneurs Group. She said, "I really have to thank you all. I'm taking notes. You have all given a lot of great comments that caused me to feel uncomfortable, which is good. And I'm going to comb through to revamp things that were suggested. Brace yourselves as I'm going to come back and ask you all to critique the changes." So what Kimberly is doing is she's doing the hard work.
Yep.
She's actively looking at her business. She's looking at what works. She's looking at what doesn't work. She's going to people for advice. She's looking for very specific marketing advice related to massage therapists who are giving her feedback for free. Thank you, Mark Zuckerberg.
Yes.
And that's why Mark Zuckerberg makes millions or whatever Mark makes, because he created the pipeline for increased communication.
Yeah.
He created the Massage Entrepreneurs Group because he gave me the platform to be able to create that. In the same way that we pay taxes, because the U.S. government and state government, to some degree, has created roads and the postal service and things that we use, utilities, to be able to build homes and build businesses to be able to keep things going. That's a perfect example of the sort of interconnectivity that happens. In addition, I had somebody write me on YouTube. This is 2 seconds ago, and I'll see if I have to pause the video on the phone here. There's a video that I made with my wife long ago, and it's called Thai Massage Handstring and Piriformis Stretch. It's got nearly 10,000 views. It's got 3 dislikes. But Alejandra, let's see, Hargbartson? Alejandra Hargbartson writes me, "Thank you, ! I was in a lot of pain, but your video helped me. Something I created on a $100 device 4 to 5 years ago is sitting, floating around the internet on YouTube and helped somebody with their back pain."
Yeah.
Now, I don't know where that person lives. Does that person right now wish they could get a session with me?
I bet they do.
And that's how you win.
Yeah.
Massage therapists don't understand when I talk about video why I'm so adamant that they go out and educate.
Right.
Because even if all they're doing is describing the process that they use to put hot towels on the person's feet, what does that potential client think when they watch the video?
They know what they're doing, they care, and they want to share that information so that other people can get the benefit of that.
And I'm like, dude, wait, I don't know if they do that in Massage Envy, but this massage therapist puts hot towels on your feet.
Exactly.
It's advertising. Advertising in the social media age particularly, it's not just selling something. Sell, sell, sell.
Yeah.
It's giving people content and letting them choose you.
Yeah. It's, we've gone, and I forget which of Seth Godin's books this was in, might have been The Purple Cow, but he was talking about that. You know, back in the golden age of TV, when TV was created to sell stuff, I don't know if you know that, but basically that's why TV was created, was to sell stuff. And a lot of companies would sponsor TV shows to sell their products, and that's where commercials came from. And at the time, there was still a lot of stuff that people needed, so you could put up a commercial and say, "Hey, we got this great refrigerator, or we got this great new toaster oven," And people are like, I gotta get that. I don't have one of those. Well, now everybody's got a refrigerator. Everybody's got a toaster oven. You know, there's really nothing that we need anymore. So now it's down to, okay, what do I want? And who do I want it from?
Wants.
Wants, yep.
Yeah. And the thing is, there are needs. I mean, utilities, running water, stuff. There are needs. But when it comes to wants, and that's where it gets really interesting, because massage in our industry, is massage a need or a want?
And it depends. Well, as massage therapists, we would say it's a need. But it depends on what the clients, you know, how they view it. I mean, if you're in pain, you need to fix that. Whether is it massage that's going to help you? Is it surgery? Is it PT? Is it all of the above?
Well, of those options, the least expensive is probably non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs or NSAIDs like naproxen.
But of course, that doesn't fix the problem.
Well, depending on what you consider fix, what I do see across the board is massage is for the most part non-invasive,
mm-hmm.
has a very low injury risk.
Yeah.
And there's not as expensive, it's not the same recuperation time as like surgery.
Yeah.
A PT, you have to go to a doctor and then get a referral to
right.
a PT.
Yeah.
So that's where massage therapists are on the edge. The problem, I think, with looking at massage as a need is people go, well, if it's a need, then people don't need to market it.
Mm. Which is, but that's not true. Even doctors have to market to some degree.
Do they? Yeah, they do, depending
hospitals
on what...
Hospitals do.
Yeah,
hospitals
depending
market.
On what they do, yeah.
And yeah, you know, it depends. It does because it, a lot of times it comes down to what network am I in, or if you're in desperate need, who's on duty. Because
I think marketing what people consider need is different than a want.
Yeah.
And here's the thing,
right.
they collide at a certain point, because let's say you decided, for whatever reason, you need a massage.
Mm-hmm.
But there are a lot of additional pieces and accoutrements that go around that need that get into wants.
Mm-hmm. True.
So when clients finish with me, I started doing this recently. I started giving clients a Topo Chico.
What is a Topo Chico? Topo
Chico is mineral water. Topo Chico, if you're watching this YouTube video, I would be happy if you would sponsor my YouTube channel. I'll put a little banner ad for it. Just cheesing. I don't know how YouTube deals with that. Topo Chico is mineral water. And here in Austin, it's kind of a hipstery thing. A lot of people, if they have a heavy night of drinking, they'll recommend having Topo Chico.
Okay.
Now, Topo Chico is interesting because it's like, when I want water, I can go to the sink and get water.
Mm-hmm.
Andrea's son doesn't like the water from the tap. He says it tastes bad. So I have to buy him water.
Yeah.
I have to spend more money to get him water.
Yes.
Now, Topo Chico wins because Topo Chico, primarily in my experience, what I like is comes in a glass bottle.
Mm.
It's classy. Right?
Yeah.
It's mineral water that has fizz.
Okay.
There's a little bit of, I think, salt added to it.
Mm-hmm.
So, in Austin, because it's so dry, we want to hydrate and drink water.
Mm-hmm.
But you get this sweet spot because sometimes you might want a soda, but you don't want all the sugar.
Right.
So with Topo Chico, it's like, it's water, but it's a party. And you'd think, well, it's not that big a deal. It's just fizzy water. It costs 60 cents.
Right.
But the look on my client's face when I give them a Topo Chico in a glass bottle, already cold and from a mini fridge,
mm-hmm.
there's something extra I just gave them.
Right.
That little bit, that additional accoutrement that went with the service,
mm-hmm.
it isn't a need.
No.
They don't need to drink water. But if I say, and I offer them, hey, would you like a Topo Chico? Sometimes I have to explain what Topo Chico is, and I'm like, it's fizzy mineral water. Because in Austin, it's one of the most Austin things I can think of doing for the client. Because I feel like they're wiped out after this 3-hour
right,
session.
Yeah.
They want something to kind of wake them up.
Mm-hmm.
And a fizzy water
yeah.
is a little more sensory oriented.
Right, right.
So
more going
I started
on.
You know, giving clients a Topo Chico. Those sorts of things add to the client's sense that I care about them
mm-hmm.
and that I went above and beyond. And I can
yeah.
guarantee you when they write the check for that session, they feel like it's worth it. Even more so, they're on a scale, if you measured the amount of happiness they had with the transaction, went up because of a 60-cent glass bottle of fizzy water.
Right. Yeah.
Because it's a want at that point.
Yeah.
Because they're like, well, no, I don't need, but the, yeah, that would be nice. I would like a Topo Chico. That sounds great.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So, no, I think you're right. There's, you know, a lot of it does come down to want, and if you fulfill the want that your client has, even if they don't know they have it quite yet, you know, it's...
And that's where it becomes psychology and emotion.
And it raises their valuation of you, saying, hey, this guy's cool. Not only did he do this great work, he offered me some fizzy
food. Food is a need. Do we need Wendy's, Whataburger, Burger King, McDonald's, let's see, what's local, Hot Dotties. Do we need all of those different kinds of burgers? In-N-Out, that's six.
We don't need them, no.
Because
we need food, we just need a way to provide.
And they're each offering a different take on the same basic stuff.
Exactly.
You can get hamburgers and french fries at all of them.
Yeah.
Right? But they're offering something unique that filters into a want for the consumer. And that's where when you start looking at massage, well, okay, if it's not a need, we can debate whether it is in fact a need. Well, what does the consumer want?
They want...
In your case.
In my case,
your business specifically.
It's two things. Relaxation, freedom from aches and pains. You know, that's... Basically, those are the two main things. Freedom from aches and pains and relaxation.
And you provide that to your consumers, and it's clear in your marketing materials that's what you do.
Mm-hmm.
I get a lot more people. It's interesting. I am very middle of the road medically, which means I think doctors are a good idea. I think physical therapists are a good idea. And if you have a herniated disc, I can work with soft tissue around your spine, but I can't do much about a herniated disc.
Right.
And that's where you need doctors to run x-rays or MRIs and mm-hmm. PTs and things with higher level skill than I have. But if your issue is with soft tissue around your spine, I'm your guy.
Yeah.
And I think that my marketing comes across that way. I regularly get clients who come in and they say, I could probably go see a physical therapist, but I want to see you. And when I ask why, they have a sort of a general kind of distrust of the medical community.
Mm, yeah.
And I'm a little apprehensive to put myself in a medical place.
Right.
And when I say that, what I mean is I don't want the client assuming I'm diagnosing and treating things
exactly.
that should be being dealt with by the doctors and PTs.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I just explain to them, listen, if you're having back pain, so in other words, if we do this session and you do not improve, you know, I would recommend that you go see a doctor,
mm-hmm.
get scans done to have them rule out other factors.
Exactly.
If it is soft tissue, then I come off looking like a miracle worker.
Right. Yeah.
And that's wonderful, but it's not about me, it's about their well-being.
Yeah. Yeah, and that's, I ran into that with, had a client who had really bad sciatica, and she's a very active lady, you know, she's off doing this, that, I mean, she drives an RV and goes to Kansas to visit her family quite regularly, and she got hit with this really bad case of sciatica, and she'd been stuck in the house for 4 days, and I'm like, call me! Anyway, call me sooner next time, but, and it took us, and it was, I worked on her probably once a week, she had a chiropractor she was going to help with that, but it took us about 6 weeks, but the first session when I came, like I said, she'd been kind of trapped in the house for 4 days because of the pain. And, you know, I just worked the glutes, the piriformis, all that area. And she got off the table. She's like, I can walk again. You know, and we still had more work to do. But that improvement, like you say, you know, it was a soft tissue. I can fix that. But I've had one or two sciatica clients that what I did didn't help them.
Yeah.
So I'm like, okay, yeah, you need to go to somebody else.
There's a small number of people, and I think what's happened when I get those clients is those clients see my website, it's professional. The SEO is decent, so they landed on my website. Mm-hmm. They look at the videos, they trust me, and then they look at the testimonials. And some of the testimonials from some of my clients will say flat out, I have worked with physical therapists and doctors and chiropractors, and nobody has helped me as much as this guy.
Yeah.
I can't even explain what he does. And that's a wonderful testimonial, but it wind up getting those clients who, like, they have a general kind of distrust about doctors. And I think what it is it's more about the quality of care they're getting from doctors.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's not that they distrust Western medicine. It's that the doctor only spends 15 minutes with me, and I go, I give you 3 hours.
Yeah.
And if it is soft tissue related, which in most of those testimonials, my suspicion is it is, and the reason why they're so crazy about what I do is they've been in pain for years, but it's because that pain is residing in their body related to their nervous system, related to soft tissue.
Mm-hmm.
And when I went in and found that tight area and had them breathe, and brought to their conscious awareness that area, their nervous system down-regulates, and goes, hey, we don't have to keep that tight anymore. It spreads.
Yeah.
They go, oh my God, because to them, that's magic.
Right, right.
And that's where they write that amazing testimonial. But when it comes to, is it a want or a need? Chronic pain is a little bit more of a need.
Mm-hmm.
But then how do those people respond when they see that testimonial? What I did is I hit a bunch of factors all in a row, from SEO, website, YouTube video, to testimonial, where they're like, I gotta make an appointment with this guy.
Yeah.
It's obvious to them that I'm doing something beyond what they consider massage.
Yeah.
Just for relaxation.
Mm-hmm.
But that's more what my target niche is, and that's where you're adding little bits of, like, what do my clients want? Because they're in pain, I made the video for Alejandra. It's been sitting on my, you know, YouTube channel forever. That person is probably subscribed to my YouTube channel.
Mm-hmm.
And that is how I win, and that is how I build a following. And I'll never forget the first time a guy from Boston wrote me. And he said, listen, you shot this video, it was myofascial pain and trigger points, part whatever, on coracobrachialis.
Right.
And I showed him how to pull his arm into his side, and coracobrachialis, you know, pops up, and you use your thumb, and you press in here. Show them how to do it safely, show them how to do it effectively, show them how to work on themselves, give them a little education. And the guy writes me and says, listen, I was in a car accident a year or two ago. I've had shoulder pain ever since, and I cannot, nobody's ever been able to help me.
Right.
And he's like, in your video, you showed me that, it's gone.
Yeah.
And his one comment was, I wish you were in Boston so I could come see you.
Yeah.
And my only thought beyond, like, yes, awesome, it worked. My only thought was, why are massage therapists in Boston not making YouTube videos that he found first?
Yeah. Yeah, and that's just it. You know, it's we live in a digital world now.
Yeah.
And
it's increasing.
Yeah. And the fact that you were able to help these people, I mean, number one, kudos to you. You've helped people feel better. So that, you know, and you didn't even lay your hands on them. You just did a video. But the fact that, you know, so there's somebody there in Massachusetts who is looking for a massage therapist, body worker, to help him in his pain. But he couldn't find them, but he found you.
To make it even more interesting, like, is it a want or a need? People are searching for massage. Occasionally somebody will see a YouTube video. They live in Arizona, so they can't come see me directly. They're not vacationing in Austin anytime soon. They will ask me, can you help me find a massage therapist who does what you do? And I go, let me check. And I'll go to Phoenix, and I'll type in whatever I think would be keywords to find something comparable to what I do, trigger point, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
They can't find anything.
Mm.
You know who shows up? Massage Envy. You know, big chains.
Yeah.
Because individual massage therapists aren't doing the work of building the business and satisfying the client's wants. All of it's going to large chain spas like Massage Envy because their marketing is better and they're more business savvy.
They have people who can do that for them, and it's they're gonna eat that up. But if you know, as an individual person, you start building that foundation, more and more people. And, you know, you when you have those keywords right for what you do, what you can help, what you do, then you're going to come out on top, you know, or maybe even, you know, Massage Envy, maybe you'll be the first one, but you'll be the second one.
Yeah.
And if they're looking, you know, and if they do, you know, a trigger point,
yeah,
myofascial release, Austin, you know.
There's a safety. There's a safety and a security with going with a large chain spa.
Yeah.
But if your website shows up on the first page, there's a subset of the population who subtly wants more intimacy.
Yeah.
And they know they can get more intimacy from an independent therapist. So the thing is, people can get a hamburger, but the reason they go to Hop Dotties is they want a place that bakes their own buns, grinds their own meat, and all of the sodas only offer cane sugar, no high fructose corn syrup.
Mm.
Because they're addressing the consumer's wants.
Yeah.
What does the consumer want? Yes, they want somebody who's professional when they come see me.
Yes.
I showed that. Yes, they want somebody who's personable. I showed them that through YouTube videos.
Yeah.
Yes, they want someone who other people say, you gotta go see this guy, it's awesome.
Right.
But I'm answering their wants increasingly. They have
exactly
a need, they need body work, we understand that.
Yeah.
But you're addressing in your session, in your little lane, yep, that little bit of extra, the Topo Chico, you're addressing what do those consumers want.
Right.
You know, your consumers are looking for pain relief, they're looking for relaxation. Now, the other component about what you do is you do alcohols.
Yes. That's true.
They want somebody who makes it convenient for them.
Yeah. It's one of those
things. They don't want to go anywhere.
Yeah. And for some of our clients, they can't go out of that, or it's very difficult for them to leave. Some of our clients just love the fact they don't have to leave their house, and when their massage is done, they can roll off the massage table, and if they want to go take a nap, go to bed, whatever.
Convenience.
Exactly.
And convenience is a want.
Yes.
They don't need someone to go to their home, but they want
it.
And they
yeah
will pay for it.
Yeah.
And that those are the things that I really think give massage therapists the edge when they figure that out. The people at the CrossFit studio, sure, they'll come to you, but how do the people at the CrossFit place feel whenever you show up to their facility where they're already there,
mm-hmm,
and you're doing little mini sessions at the facility and they don't have to go anywhere?
Right.
It's not a need.
It's a convenience.
But they sure want
it.
Yeah. It's like, I don't need a hamburger at 3 o'clock in the morning, but In-N-Out knows I want it. And they're open.
Exactly.
And they'll provide that through the drive-thru. Because they figured out that other burger places were closed and that they made more money when they were willing to keep the hours, and there's a subset of the marketplace that wants to come out at 3 o'clock
yeah
in the morning.
Yeah.
Yeah. Targeting your client's wants. Often what they purchase, in my experience, is more of an emotional need.
Yeah.
It's more of an emotional transaction
yeah
than it is a logical transaction.
Yeah, I think most people, until you're aware of this, and even people who are aware of it, you know, like in real estate, people who are real estate investors, they go, they look at a house because they're like, okay, I want to flip this or I want to rent it out, you know, so they're looking at the numbers. When you're going to look at, to buy your first house, it's very emotional. So there's, you know, some people can turn one off or the other, but a lot of times most decisions that people make, there's an emotional component. They want it for whatever reason. And it may be, you know, I'm in pain. So they need something to fix the pain, but they want, you know, but they want it to be done with trigger points or hot stones, or they want it to be taken care of at their home. And it's, you know, it's that want that you have to, that will drive that transaction and drive people to your door, or you to their door, as opposed to the benefits. You can tell people, oh, I do Swedish, I do deep tissue massage, I do trigger point, I do this, but if you're not meeting their needs, you know, I'm going to fix you, I'm going to make you feel better, I can relieve your pain, and I can do it using all of these techniques. Then people are like, I go to you. You know, if you do a search and you see a list of 5 different massage therapists and there was nothing to differentiate between the 5, you're like, no, eeny, meeny, miny, mo.
And the therapists wonder why when. They're like, we don't understand. I've talked to male therapists at Time Massage Jam, and they'll sit around and talk to each other, and they start complaining about what they're making. They're complaining about their income.
Mm-hmm.
Say, I make, you know, $22, $25 an hour. And they'll say, Robert, well, you know, how much did you make today? And I'm like, well, before I showed up to the jam, I made $400 today. And they almost lose their minds.
Right.
They're like, what do you... I'm like, listen, I had two clients. I worked 6 hours before I even came to this event.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm telling them, I've been telling you for years how to do it. And massage therapists won't listen. Because you don't just take in information. You have to do what I'm doing. Like, I talk about social media. No. Don't just ask me questions about social media. Get your smartphone, follow me on Twitter, follow me on Instagram, follow me on Snapchat, follow those social media platforms and watch what I do. And the thing is, I'm still learning how to maximize all those channels, but I'm working at it. And when you see what I'm doing, then you copy what I'm doing. Look at people in your industry who are winning.
Yeah.
And replicate what they're doing. When I watch Gary Vee videos, yes, I like talking to Gary Vee, and I like feeling like I'm hanging out with Gary Vee having a beer. But the thing is, what I'm doing is I'm looking at what Gary is doing, and I'm replicating what Gary is doing.
Exactly.
Because he is winning, and I want to win.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, and that's just the key, is you have to watch the people who are succeeding, because, you know, your broke cousin who tells you, oh, you can't make any money doing that, well, he can't because he's broke, you know, he obviously hasn't done anything, but, you know, you listen to people who are succeeding, you try, and you know, you're not just going to go out and totally rip off what Robert's doing, what Gary's doing, but you take your own twist on it, and you move forward, and you start trying, you start doing. There was an interesting quote, it's lost me, come back to it, because it was there and then left. But anyway, you know, the quote, knowledge is power, and I don't know if this was a Gary Vee change on it, but somebody said, knowledge is not power. Knowledge, and then acting on that knowledge, is power. That's where it comes from, because you can read all the books. We can sit and watch Gary Vaynerchuk videos all day long, but if we never did anything, we would never get remotely where Gary is.
Yeah.
So it's, you know, doing is so important. And so, yes, you have to learn, you have to research, you have to watch what other people are doing, but then you have to go and make your decision. And sometimes you get kind of stuck in that analysis paralysis. You're like, shoot, okay, I gotta do this. Pick one, make your stand, and start.
Well, when it comes to, like, needs and wants, you're using social media to test the marketplace.
Yeah.
So you have one ball.
Exactly.
You have one ball that's Facebook. And what you're going to do is you're going to toss that one ball. And you're going to get really comfortable, and you can have a conversation and sit and do this.
Mm-hmm.
And then after you figure out Facebook, you're like, oh, okay, that's how they're using Facebook. Oh, okay, that makes sense. You get likes.
Yeah.
People are commenting on your posts. Then you go, what about, you know, Twitter? And you have to keep doing it because you're going to drop it. Like,
yeah.
But the thing is, when you keep going and you keep adding channels and you keep adding diversity and you add platforms and you continue to figure out what do people want on social media to get attention, to get traffic, to get noise, that is where you're consistently going, because people aren't on Facebook always because they have a need. They want to be on Facebook.
Yep.
They want to see pictures of their grandkids. They want to keep in touch with their friends in a quick, easy format. And that's what Mark Zuckerberg gave them. You're looking at consumer wants through your social media.
Yeah.
Why do I post pictures of tacos? Hashtag tacos. Hashtag Austin on Instagram.
To engage.
Because people who are not interested in body work at all, necessarily.
Yeah.
I gave them a cool photo of breakfast tacos I made yesterday with local pork You know, local farm eggs with a little potato and like scallion.